travelers, and welcome back. Some changes have taken place. Mainly, Lydia looks different now. Hey, turn around and look at me, darn it. Alright, so, Lydia, when I tried to get in here to record about, I don't know, half an hour ago, her face was completely black, and when this usually happens, you go somewhere else, like go through a door, fast travel to somewhere, and it would fix it. Not this time. I would try reloading and doing all sorts of stuff, and it would not fix it. So she just had, like, a very dark red face, and it didn't look very nice, and I hated it. So if I wanted to keep her looking like she did before, even if I wanted to, I couldn't. So I had to change it, but this looks pretty nice. You don't look like you slapped on 50 pounds of makeup before going into battle. Meeko got reset, his texture reset, so he wasn't husky, but then I fixed it. And also, I have turned off God rays, because I think it was, making the video lag, but I'm not sure. That's just something I'm gonna have to figure out once the video is over. So, you, go on. Hey.
Let me know if you have anything you need from me.
Cool. I think we're good. Meeko can't equip anything. Let's get out of here. So, now it's time to go on our adventure. It's time to start our journey up the 7,000 steps to High Hrothgar, the monastery of the Greybeards. People are still outside at, well, 9 o'clock. It's earlier than what it is in real life right now. Right now it's about 11, so that's fun. So, yeah, I'm just...
It has been too long since I tasted it.
You know that our supply is limited. It could be a season or more before we get a new shipment from the south.
My ears hear the truth in your words, and yet my body shakes with the need.
Control yourself. Do not frighten away our customers with your fits.
Yes, of course, you are right. Still, I would give much for even a few grains of moon sugar.
Put the thought out of your mind, and do not speak of it again.
Alright, for those of you who don't know, moon sugar is basically a drug made in Elsewhere. So, approach this camp with caution. Just be careful. Hello, friends.
The road makes this one weary.
I imagine.
Take a look.
What do you got, actually? These guys usually have some okay stuff. But I don't remember what I have, so let's see. Oh, wait, I have to go. Oh, man. So I've got an Imperial Sword, that's a pretty good one. Got an Iron Warhammer, two Iron Swords.
May your road lead you.
I've got stuff to sell you, bro.
Take a look.
You say you benefit off of... Nope, that's not the one that I want. You say that you benefit off of war? I can help you instigate it. Got an orcish bow, so I don't need that. Nor do I need that. Imperial light bracers? What do I got? Yeah, I want this more. Let's keep that, just in case. I don't know. You never know what you could need. Alright, and nope, I don't want to buy an amethyst. I want to sell one, and I sell a garnet. Let's sell this human skull that we found in the wilds. Why not? Wolf pelts. Don't need those. Sell that. Yeah, we need all that food. Happy stomach equals happy adventure. I I wonder if I should get Lydia some, like, other equipment, because I think
I hope that you will come to do business with us again.
I don't know, maybe I...
to admire their courage, doing something like that with dragons on the loose and a war going on.
Yeah. Yeah, I do. The Khajiit are pretty awesome kind of people. Hang on real quick. I need to make sure that it's actually recording. Okay, yeah, it is recording my voice. Fantastic. Let's put that there. Sorry about that. Whoa! Hey! Fist fight. No, not really.
Goods and wares of all kinds, and all can be yours.
Nah, I'm good. So I'm just gonna equip my bow. No, I think I fixed my mouse sensitivity. Thank you, clock. Right on time, too. Wow, it's the first time in a while. How much money do we have? 2,682. I could buy a horse, or I could do something really crazy and try and steal a horse. I don't know about that, though. I don't want a horse following me around, either. So I'm just gonna stick to good old-fashioned walking. Walking around Skyrim isn't that bad. Hey, Nernroot! Look at this. The mystical plant of singing. Seriously, though, there's not much known about that plant. At least that I know. There could be some book somewhere in the Elder Scrolls lore that I'm completely overlooking. It's like, it says that all the Nernroot was created by the dwarves in ancient times, and it was planted in the ground all over the place, and it's supposed to spy on... Excuse you? It's supposed to spy on the other races of Tamriel while the dwarves are away. Something like that would happen. It's not too far-fetched, given the nature of Pelennor Whitestrake. Or supposed. Hang on. I'll explain in just a second. Hey, you. Who are you? You're... bad guy? Good guy?
Yes.
Hello!
I'm collecting ingredients to bring to the gourmet. He'll think my taste's so refined when I offer them to him.
Okay.
You have heard of the gourmet?
Never heard of him.
You've not heard of the gourmet? Author of Uncommon Taste? He is a wizard with a spatula. Well, not an actual wizard, but his recipes are legendary. You know, I've heard the gourmet is in Skyrim right now.
Nice. I don't really care. I've got dragon stuff to deal with, and you're like, ugh, cooking, though. Oh, man. Spit just went down the wrong pipe. The only reason I would care
what was that?
If you about your cooking would be is if you made me some.
Only a fool lets himself gets around.
Oh, man. That was nasty. Alright, so we got a stone up here, but I'm pretty sure I can never remember. Thief stone. Yeah, let's keep that one. But we're going to go up here. And it's night, too, so it'll be easier to sneak. So there should be... bad guy up here. Oh no. Okay. What? Okay, you stop. There we go. Headshot. Hey. Wait, why aren't you dying? Yeah, You're supposed to die when the summoner who summoned you died. That's how it works. Idiots. Good. Necromancer robes. Don't want that. Ritual stone makes it so that we can reanimate nearby corpses. I don't want that. Because I'm going to forget about it, and I don't like bringing people back to life. It's not a pretty sight, so don't wish for it. I don't remember the actual line. Sorry. Anybody who has Aladdin memorized perfectly, like... Oh. I was gonna say, whoever has that line memorized perfectly, like Robin Williams. But, Anyways... moving on from very morbid subjects, let's see, there's a bunch of bandits here. What the heck are you doing? Hello? What? She's very upset with those deer. Are you just gonna... You won't get the best of me. Are you gonna...
Oh, well. Must have run off.
What? What? Huh? What is wrong with you? So we're gonna wait, because we are honorable.
Hold it. This here's a toll road, see? You're gonna have to hand over, say, 200 gold if you want to use our road.
How about you let me through and I don't kill you?
Huh. Tough talk for someone who's about to have their guts spilled.
All right, team.
No,
draw weapons.
Surprise.
Whoa, wrong weapon. Oops, sorry. Nope, we're good. We good. Okay. Sneak. Hey, look. Stuff. Okay, cool. Goodbye. And let's unlock this trap trigger. Nope. There we go. That mace won't fall on us. Ooh, level up. Huh. Still looks like I got a bit of God rays in there, though. I don't know why that is. Oh well. I don't care. Looks pretty.
Anybody there?
Huh?
Is someone there?
Come on. Come over here, darn it. It's great.
Nothing here after all. What was that?
Come over here.
Oh no, you don't.
Nope.
Last of them.
Nope. Be quiet. Don't make a sound. There we go. Okay. Now it's time to look over here. Can't tell if anybody's over there. Darn it. Curse you, recording software. Now I can't see where people are. Oh well. Meeko? No. No, hovering in midair and balancing on the table with your tail is not acceptable. Give me this. Also, Meeko, we've talked about this. That's bad manners. Sheesh. Training pets, am I right? Shh. What? Oh, straight into the side. Hang on. What do we got? I'm gonna increase Magicka, because we might use some skills in that. Or some spells, rather. Let me see. Got that. Sneak attack. Oh, what? Ooh, we need to level up sneak. Must have been your imagination. Don't.
Is someone there?
Here. Come on. I dare you. Come in here. Come in here. Alright, pull out.
That's all you've got?
Can't get in it. Oh, there we go. Enough of this. That was awesome. Racers. Here. You can have this, Lydia. Take this one. This one looks nice. So I'm going to be back in just a second. I need to figure some stuff out. With Lydia's stats to see what she should use for armor and weapons
I've
and
got
such.
Your back.
Yeah, you do. Alright, back to business. I didn't have a stealthy Lydia mod on, so she's just.
I've got your back.
She's got heavy armor. Give her the armor from that guy. And she's already got a cape, so I don't want to put that cape on her, and helmets look stupid. Get out of my inventory. Yeah.
Yes, my thing.
Yeah, get out of the way. So, she's gonna use two-handed, I guess. Okay, what do we have up here? Oh, that's good. I just holy spark slow. Okay. Huh. Nice. Hey. Lid dog, L dog, whatever.
I'm right behind you. I am at your command.
I've got something for you. I've got. Here, take this. There
Let's
you
get
go.
Going then.
That'll do more two-handed damage. There we go. So, that was pretty good. Got some good stuff. Oh yeah, that's something else that I was gonna do. I was gonna wait till daytime. Whoa, wow, just rocketed up those stairs. But instead of waiting around like an idiot, let's sleep in this bed. With Meeko and Lydia guarding me. Excuse me, where's Meeko? What? Is he defying the laws of physics again? No, he's not. Okay. At least I don't think he is. Could be in between phases of reality for all I know. Anyways, let's move and go to the Greybeards. Whoa, hello. Oh, it's a little lamppost. I think this is a mod that I installed. That's nice. Lighting the way. Awesome. There's a rabbit. Everything is beautiful, he said as the sky suddenly turned gray and started raining. It's the fox! It's a fox. Where's it leading us? Holy cow! That is something interesting, Mr. Fox. See? Follow foxes and you find cool stuff. What are you...
Wonder what's inside?
Oh, that's something I need to... you to not do. That's really obnoxious. Combat? No. Actions. I might edit this out if I can't find it. Oh, wait, here it is. There we go. Followers catch up on weapon draw.
Very good, sir.
Unrealistic and kind of obnoxious. Whoa, holy cow. This lady died. Darkshade. You want to go inside? I stubbed my toe on something. Bandit. I need to bind torches to 6. There you go. Alright. What's gonna be in here? Ben, what? Huh? What's gonna be in here? Everywhere. It's a mess. Fur armor? Ew. Okay. Sounds like a frost troll. Nope, just regular troll.
Come on.
Okay, what do I got? I need a flames. Ah! Oh!
The last of them.
Stabbed you through your jaw. Let's take all that. Anybody else? Anybody else want some? Huh? Oh, here another one. Everybody. Don't beat up my dog. Or my new friend.
Now that's how it's done.
Yeah. That is how it's done. Very good. Alright, let's wait. You okay, Meeko? Licked your wounds sufficiently? Awesome. Is there anything up here? Gotta get all the secrets. You. Okay. Hey. You're ugly. And I don't like you. Hey, you can't do that. Nope. Down it with arrows.
Sorry,
there we go.
You left me with no
got him.
Choice.
Awesome. Ooh, there's more. Come on, come on. More arrows. More arrows. More arrows. Come on. Put more arrows in him. Burn him. Burn him. Burn him. Oh. Whoa. Oh. Yeah. That's what we do to trolls on the internet and in fantasy RPGs. Yeah, take that. Oh, look, a gourd. Oh, hey, a rabbit. Orsinium and the orcs. Heavy armor increased. Never gonna use that. Might use it, like, once or twice. Alright, let's... Is there anything over there? Is there anything behind the waterfall? No, that looks like a pretty solid waterfall. What's over here? Is this the way that I came? Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Everybody over here. Oh. I need help. Where did he come from? Where'd he go? Where'd he come from, Cotton Eye Joe? Level 9. Alright. Guys, if you ever want to know more and be better than you are now, just beat up a couple of trolls. It's not that hard. Okay. Use magic a lot now. Let's save. Wait, no. I was already saving a perk. So, let's go over to destruction. Destruction mastery. Increasing your pest effectiveness and cost. You resolve to continue pushing yourself. Perhaps there's more to you than you thought, Janarus. I'll say, you just killed a couple of trolls. Oh, there's a Dunmer. Oh, hey! It was worth it after all. Nord male heavy coif. Heck no. Is it worth a lot? That's worth a decent amount of gold. Does this way lead out? Oh. No. Okay, there's a secret over here. No.
Oh.
Yeah, you better. Ow. That's what I should be saying to you, because you're in my way. Alright, so there was a secret up here. Not very much of a secret, since it was very clearly marked by a torch. But we're going to call it a secret, because, whoa, is there? Nope, this is just a little place to hide and read your books. So let's read a book. Don't have enough time. Myths of Shir-Gorath. In the earliest of days, in a time when the world was still raw, Shir-Gorath decided to walk amongst the mortals. He donned his guise of a gentleman with a cane, and he moved from place to place without being recognized. After elven days and elven nights, Shir-Gorath decided that life among mortals was even more boring than his otherworldly existence. "What can I do to make their lives more interesting?" he said to himself. At that same moment, a young woman nearby commented wistfully to herself, "The sounds of the birds are so beautiful." Shir-Gorath silently agreed with her. Mortals can not make the beautiful and inspired calls of birds. Their voices were wretched and mundane. He could not change the nature of mortals, for that was the purview of other Daedric princes. However, he could give them tools to make beautiful sounds. Shir-Gorath took hold of the pinchfoot woman and ripped her asunder. From her tendons he made lutes, from her skull and arm bones she made a drum. He made a drum. From her bones he made flutes. He presented these gifts to mortals, and thus music was born. Sounds like Shir-Gorath. That was a great book, guys. I loved it. There's a dead guy. Never got a chance to grow his hair back. So let's... That was a little interesting tidbit of lore. Not entirely sure how accurate it is. And I got an orcish sword. This is cool. Orcish sword. This is better, right? 13 to 12. Yeah, a little bit better. Also, looks really freaking cool. Oh, man. Shia Gorath. There's not a lot of reoccurring characters in the Elder Scrolls, seeing as between games, hundreds of years pass, pretty much. But there are some, like, characters, immortal characters, and characters in books that are pretty freaking awesome. I think my two personal favorite are Shia Gorath and Pelennor Whitestrake. Shia Gorath because he's funny, and Pelennor Whitestrake because in the lore it's hinted at the fact that he's actually a robot. Or a cyborg. One of the two. He's got robot parts. Millium Septim Man. There it is. Alright, so that was a cool adventure. But I've been going for quite a while, so I'm probably going to have to leave you here, my good travelers. What did I say? I'm going to have to leave you here, travelers. Thank you for joining me on this next chapter of Janarus, the Thief's Adventure. Hopefully in the future, we will be able to make it to High Hrothgar without any more distractions or interesting stories like the one we just read. Anyways, I'm going to leave you here. Well, have a good day. Farewell, travelers.